Now, whatever your religious colour or lack of one, a story tailor-made for Good Friday. It's a room quite literally filled with the pages of history, the Pope's personal library. It's usually off-limits to the public, but as you're about to see, it's really a roadmap back to biblical times.
If St. Peter's Basilica represents the splendour of the church writ large, the library nearby is a testament to the monks and scribes who made magnificent miniatures in times past. Here, some devotional music commissioned by Pope Leo X, and the text of the Christmas Mass used at the altar by Alexander VI, both manuscripts 5 centuries old, written on parchment, treated animal skin.
This is the Urbino Bible.
This spectacular Bible commissioned in 1476 by the Duke of Urbino.
He wanted to have a very fancy Bible.
Well, here you go.
And this is what he got.
Library curator Timothy Jans tells us the Bible took years to make by hand, letter by letter, picture by picture.
Decorated with real gold.
It's just one of the library's 80,000 handwritten manuscripts from the ages before the printing press. Add to that those 2 million or so printed books, Christian and pagan, sacred and profane, in virtually every language known to man. There are thousands of prints and drawings.
Il Campidoglio.
Windows on the past.
E questa è una moneta papale.
And a huge collection of ancient coins. This was the money of Palestine 2,000 years ago, including the kind of silver coins Judas was said to have been paid to betray Christ. Here is a map of the world, drawn 50 years before Columbus. Father Michael Collins is an Irish priest who's written extensively about the Vatican, where the library's shelves, if you put them end to end, would stretch for 31 miles.
Is there anyone, any single person who really knows what the library holds?
Nobody knows exactly what's there, because it would be impossible for the human brain to understand, to remember the titles, who wrote it, when they were written.
By the mid-17th century, navigators had mapped much of the world in remarkable detail.
Rio de Janeiro, Cusco, Mexico City.
Galileo turned his eyes and his telescope on the heavens. Here, from 1612, are his drawings of sunspots. For his insistence that the sun is the center of the universe and the earth moves round it, the church branded him a heretic. Leaving the library, we thought, there's something almost magical to be immersed in this place, to breathe the air and touch the hand of history.